Okay. I don't see my numbers double digiting up like it has been, like my phone tag. But I know, there's still some stuff going on with my phone. So, the journey has been long. It has been an experience. But needless to say, when God tells you to do something, you should do it. And I'm definitely learning a lot more. I have learned a lot more. And we will always forever be learning and growing and helping each other do so. Whew. So it's just been a lot of people, Oh shit, there goes the doubling of the digits, the blurring of the digits. Okay, but whatever. Which is the reason for my little setup right here. So when God, tell you to do something, you do it. So God was just like, go. And so I went. And then, things happened in between that time. And of course, Archangel Michael come through and block off anybody trying to tap into my portals, please and thank you. That is any of a lower vibrational energy. Cut them off, please and thank you. Love you, appreciate you. Much gratitude and appreciation. So, as I was saying, gone through that, and then I just been really having to be in reclusion. I've been trying to anyways, and of course dealing with all of the situations that I have going on. And of course I still do not have access to my Facebooks, but those who do know who you are, and that's gonna be handled. But anyways, but God has was just like, sit, be patient, be quiet. I'm just like, what? I'm over here having a fucking stroke at some point. For the most part, I'm pretty calm, cool, collected, and I can handle my myself pretty well under a multitude of situations. But it just got to this one point where I just like, boy, you could have heard the conversation I had with God and my ancestors and my spirit guides. I was just like, who is this? What is going on? I'm so sick of this. I am about to lose my rabbit and everything because me and the old me was trying to jump out the bag. And needless to say, I grounded myself, gained my composure, and separated myself and secluded myself for a minute as long as I could, and I'm having to do so right now again. And it's the best thing for me. It really is, because I'm so not around like-minded people, and it's trying to say the least. And that it's really hard when you're an empath and you're around energies like that. It's not the easiest thing to do, to say the least. Snacking on some granolas and stuff and trying to keep my energy clear as possible, and deep cleansing is very important right now. Oh, drinking a lot of water. I've been definitely drinking a lot of water if I have not been eating the heck out of some ice. Funny little story. Found some dirt, which I believe is graveyard dirt, in my ice. And it's just been a lot of funny, weird stuff going on. And yeah, got tired of it, and I know I am. And it's just been, like I said, me trying not to choke the crap out of people that have been testing me. I learned that I do have more patience to grow. And they get like that sometimes dealing with, you know, different situations. And y'all just gonna have to really protect yourself and, you know, cross your I's, dot the T's. And I really need to get into it more as soon as I get to my. Man, I'm telling you, I'm craving self-sufficiency right now. Not even self-sufficiency, it's just like being in my own space. I've learned how to be by myself, and I really freaking like it. Because when I try to interact with other people that do not understand, or just hardly ever, you know, run into those few like-minded people, it's, you know, it's a temporary thing, but it's well welcome and appreciated, because it helps me take a lot more breaths of fresh air. And, you know, they're definitely uplifting when I do come across those people. They're like, oh, you're so freaking awesome, and you are like amazing, your aura and whatnot, you know, and I love it. But it has been some crazy shit going on. I was working at a place, and the store manager and the manager stole my shit. I think I mentioned this on my last video. Don't know, but if it didn't, there it is. It's been a lot. When I tell you, these people just craving this karma. That's just what it is, and I got a bit of my own karma too, because yeah, I just need to read into energy a lot more and be patient. A lot to do with that. So regrounding myself, regrouping, and being patient with myself, and yeah, just doing a lot of that. That is. I'm just glad that my kids are not with me right now, at this time and moment, with me going through this last little bit of what I gotta go through. And, you know, I'm always sending them my love and comfort and healing energy, and especially for those who help support me and, you know, on this journey. And I appreciate you guys so much, and loving and caring and support. I'm not gonna say I'm fine. I'm good. I can hold my own for now, and, you know, for these men that don't like to be responsible for their children and try to do really critical, nasty things to the mother of their children, or these families that do that, like, it's really pointless, and it was really reckless with the things that have been done. But I can't wait for it to all be over, because it's pretty damn ridiculous that anybody should have to go through anything like that, whether they be a mother or not. Whether they be have a job or not, you know, these things go on quite frequently, you know, the gang stalking and the craziness, you know. And then, you know, people want to say, oh, you crazy, no, honey, but God was like, I'm gonna show y'all something. So God is showing y'all plain and clear for everybody to see, and that's what I had to wait for. I made a video, it was like, I'm gonna expose the names. Well, no, it didn't happen that way. And God was like, wait. And I was like, what? Wait. Why? But I'm ready. And, you know, God was like, I know you ready. But, you know, just be patient and see. And I had to see. Oh. The cat came out the bag in a major way. And it's going to be internationally all over the world for, you know, these dirty people in these different corporations and businesses and different things like that. And you know, basic down to the, from the bottom to the top. Ain't nobody being hit nor missed. And that if you create karma, you put out, that's what you're going to receive, what you put out. If you're putting out positive, loving, and healing energy, that's what you're going to get back. If you're putting out hate and, you know, discrimination and controversy, that's what you're going to get back. You know what I mean? That's just what it is. I was eating some olives, green olives to be exact. But, you know, you, shit, I'm good. I'm good on my karma, and whatever I put out, I know I'm going to get back. And I'm like, thank you, God. Thank you. And I can't say it no more. No, I can't. I'm going to keep on saying it. Thank you for teaching me how to take the high road. Because I've looked back at videos, and I've seen where, you know, I was actually channeling. I didn't know I was channeling. But, and then from learning and watching other mentors that I've had, and didn't really know to understand that they were my mentors, and because of all the fucking craziness I was going through. But thank you. Taking the high road will save you some bad karma. Not choking somebody can save you time from going to jail, because you could just let them sit and wallow in the victory that they think they have in over you, and then they get slapped by God, slapped by your ancestors, slapped by your guardian angels, your arch guardian angel. And it's a wonderful thing, because you ain't got to put your hands on nobody. You ain't got to cuss nobody out. But even if they, you know, sometimes you might have to, and Lord forbid somebody put their hands on you, and somebody probably came by that close, and I'm like, oh, please don't do it, because I don't want to do that. I don't want to fight. I don't want to argue. I'm not that type of person. I love peace, calmness, and happiness. I love it, and I just don't even like to get, I don't even like to raise my voice. And if I do, it's like, I've been poked and poked and poked. It's like poking a bear. It ain't no fun when the rapper got the gun. So, I'm just leave it at that. But besides that, you know, everything is coming out. Things are going to be healed. Things are going to be transformed. Like I said before, you know, these are things that have to be done. These generational curses that have to be broken. Families and people that need to learn how to heal within, and stop trying to just fix other people. If you're not going to help them help themselves, or show them how they can help themselves, you know, explain to them mentally, physically, emotionally, if you're not equipped to, just stay in your lane. Like, mind your business, period. You know, let them be. You know, and sometimes people just gotta learn by experience. You know, we all have to at some point in time. So it's just like, help where you can, and don't try to like trip somebody up and make them fall, because you don't know what they had to go through to get there. A lot of people look at me like, oh, you're so happy, you got a great smile and da 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 da. But yeah, they don't know what I'm going through at that moment in time, or what I had to go through from past points to now to get where I'm at. They don't know, and they don't take the time out to even talk, to ask, to understand. And then even if they do, you know, some people take that as, oh, this is the go button to, like, let me try my point to try to take this advantage. And you get your ass whooped by karma, quite frankly. God ain't playing about me. And nobody else that is divinely protected. So, see how you want to float your boat. But if you're not going to help nobody and be a positive affirmation, inspiration, and constructive criticism, you will need to leave them alone. These children and these women and these men that are being abused, that are being neglected, elders, you know, they need help and they need healing. And somebody got to start somewhere. Somebody got to be the bigger person. Somebody got to take the higher road. Somebody got to walk away. So when people do that, it's not, you know, and I had to come to that understanding too, because I used to not understand how God's rejection was my protection. And I'm a firm believer now. I'm like, okay, God, shoot, I can accept no. And I've preached that, and I've talked about that before, and you know how I learned how to accept no about almost 5 years ago from now. It's probably 4 or 5 years now that I've been talking about, you know, healing myself, healing my inner child, my masculine, my feminine, and just healing those, whatever traumas, the, you know, the nasty things that people have said to you that made you feel insecure, that made you, you know, probably ruin a relationship with somebody, whether it been a personal or intimate relationship, or even just like somebody you were working with. And, you know, those type of things are needed to learn how to heal. It's not always easy looking from the outside. You know, if you're not that person, and something you gotta understand as well, gifts, people's way of being that they have, because I used to look at terror reviews and I'm like, damn, I don't want to do that, and not knowing I was already doing it. I used to be like, you know, I want to know how to do that. I want to learn how to do that and I could be better. It wasn't about being better, it's about being me. When you learn how to be you and learn how to perfect you and heal you and love you, you can teach and show other people how to do the same thing. And I'm so glad I've taught my kids to do that. You know, I'm so glad that I've learned how to do that. And I had to take time out just to be by myself and really learn and actually be willing to change. What did I have to change? I would look at myself in the mirror. I would sit down to myself, even with my kids around. I would be sitting there like, what do I need to change to be even better for myself as a mother, as a friend, as a sister, as a daughter, as an aunt? I always question these things. It didn't even matter if I was interacting with my family or not. What perspectives as a businesswoman, how could I better myself? You know, how can I help other people better themselves? And so all the aspects in me I found that, you know, could be tweaked in the experience that I've had with other people, learning those ins and outs of ebb and flows. I've learned a lot, and helping people gather those, giving them like seeing their perfect imperfections or things that they can, you know, authenticate about themselves and things that they don't see that they're doing wrong, being able to point that out in a kind way and say, hey, this is how the A, B, and C got started from way back here. This is how you can fix it from getting to there. You know, those are the major things that you can help somebody change their life. It can be something so simple. And people don't understand, yeah, I'm young. I just turned 34 from 33, but I have a lot of experience I had to go through in order to get this knowledge, in order to get this wisdom, you know. And then not only that, you know, learning my natal chart, my birth chart, something that, you know, these beings know before you even, right before you get in or even before you hear. They know what time you're born. So that's an important part to know, is your natal chart, knowing yourself, because they'll put you on a total different path that you are not even supposed to be on. You know, you're put here for a purpose, and God wants you to know your purpose. And you will be in like some type of turmoil and chaos until you do so. And then it's not to say that you won't be, but you'll have a better balance in that, in the advantage of knowing that's your blueprint, that's your pink print, that's your yellow, red, blue, purple, pink, yellow, I'm pretty sure I just said that, orange, violet, golden, silver print. It's your own authentic rainbow print, indigo print, starseed print. That's yours. For you to learn and authenticate about yourself, you will be a very better being and loving to yourself. And once you learn how to love yourself, you can love others. And that is deep. It's real deep, because I didn't know how much I didn't love myself before. And I'm glad that I really took the time out to do so. Because when I did, I seen a whole new world. I seen things I never thought I'd see before. I done things and thought of things that I never thought I could be able to do to help people, to help my own children, even to help myself. You know, and that's something I'm very proud of. And that's what makes me happy. And I can really say that, man, like, you don't know how happy and what happy is until past my bedtime. Until, you know, you go on a healing journey and you try it. Because we've been taught to be scared of ourselves, and it's nothing to be scared of. These are actual factual things. That's ancient history. Use it to the best of your advantage for the greater good. Don't use it for low vibrational hateful things, because that's all you're going to get out of it. And that's proof in the pudding. You know, even before I didn't know myself, it wasn't too much things I really did to take anything from anybody, you know. Like, I've been done, not in that way. I've done some things. I've stolen from stores, you know, and I don't even steal no more. It's been years. But, you know, even that accumulates karma. The hell? But I played off my karmic debt. And I'm so happy. Because, as you see, I'm a bit tired. And I need some rest. Even though my face looks beat without makeup right now. And I was going to sit on here and put on some makeup, but it's too late for all that. So I ain't going to do nothing but, like, be irritated that it's on my face. Anyway. But, it is quite a refreshing journey. It's not the easiest. It's called the Dark Night of the Soul. And it is some dark shit. Your shadow self that you're going to have to face. And then, not only are you going to be facing your shadow side, you're going to be facing other people's shadow side. As you're going through this journey. You're going through it already. So you might as well go through it, get through it, and be done with it. And then, hey, you can help some other people along the way. And that's just the way it goes. Each one, teach one, you know, show a man how to fish. And, you know, he can feed himself for a lifetime, but we ain't no fish around here. We eat fruits and vegetables. Okay? And drinking lots of water, like a fish. Oh, my side hurt. But, yeah, and going vegan is very important. Dr. Sabin teached it, taught it, and did it well, you know, in terms of girl. And, you know, they killed him for it. You know, they killed Nipsey Hussle because he was going to do a remake of the, oh my God, why does it always slip my mind? Right, well, a documentary about Dr. Sabin. They said it was because something else, no, it wasn't because of that. It was because of the health factor in dealing with, trillion-dollar companies like the pharmaceuticals down to, this, you know, the corporations, because they all are in cahoots with each other. And that's how they make their money off of the pyramid scheme that they have, you know, pretty much reversed out of the natural elements it's supposed to be in. Because then nobody would be suffering, nobody would be poor, nobody would be, you know, everybody would be a lot more balanced. Everybody would be knowing themselves for one. They wouldn't have to find out this way, you know, through a video, not off news, that, you know, there's another natural way, getting knowing your blueprint and how to heal yourself with natural remedies, plants, fruits, and vegetables. And, you know, knowing your natal chart is, this is a natural way of being, and this will keep and bring a balance to everyone. You know, some people just don't want to live their life that way, and, you know, just stay to yourself and, you know, have your own piss party or whatever, but don't bother nobody that's not doing it to you. I mean, at the same time, you can't say that too. Because it's like, even if somebody is doing that to you, just like I said, taking the high road, people doing that shit to me right now, it's just like, I'm having to just be humble and just step away. Be it and let, you know, God take care of it. Because that's just the way it is. Because energy never dies and only transfers, you know. It's, unless the energy heals itself, it's not going to change. Even if you do kill that person for, you know, hurting you, harming you, stealing something from you, or doing something but basically like stepping on your shoe. Even if you do kill that person, that energy is only going to transfer it to another body and be reborn back here. It's not going to get the time, the chance to heal and know itself and grow and transform out of here and go to its higher purpose. And do we do have a lot that, you know, are able to send their energy to help guide us here. That's what ancestors and spirit guides are. You know, it's a part of God. They are here to help us. They're here to guide us. You know, they are malevolent and benevolent beings. You know, just what energy are you going to choose? Are you going to choose to heal? What energies are you going to choose? Are you going to choose to heal? So, you know, just like pick your poison. I picked mine and I picked the best one. And I almost want to say I'll do it again, but I hope and I pray, God, please don't make me do this again. I'll come back, but not like this. Not like this. I'll come back and help people, but not like this. I just, you know, I'll be ready to go to my higher self, into God, quite honestly. But, you know, we are some hard-headed beings. It's hard because we are solid mask is so, you know what I mean? We are thick. They are of light beings, like, you know how they say, what is it? The speed of light. That's what angels are, the speed of light. That's what, you know, high level beings are, and there's some lower level beings that are like that as well. But being as light, I'd rather come back as light than to come back in this physical form. And teach and heal and help people. But I'm definitely going to do my job while I'm here in this form because I know what my purpose is. And it's what I'm going to continue to do. And I'm glad my good ear is ringing because, I'm just so glad that it is ringing. But yeah, it's an awesome experience. You know, it's definitely an experience of ups and downs. It You know, it all depends on what your ancestors did, you know, what you did in your past life, what, you know, what your ancestors did in their past life. You know, there is more healing to do than just this physical body right here and right now. So, you know, you call on your higher ups and cut off your lowers, your lower energies. You ask for your higher, our guardians, ancestors, spirit guides, elements, and centers of the highest order, God, the universe, Pachamama, Yemaya, come through rainbow Reiki fire and clear away any negative lower vibrational beings' energy from me. You know, and of course, you know, it comes with cleansing. And that could be anything from oil sprays, you know, you pick what you like, and, you know, because a lot of people don't like smoke in their car or, you know, different things. There's definitely a plethora of things that you could do. Gems, crystals, you know, that's to help you connect and make the bond stronger and help protect you as well from other beings or other energies trying to get into your, you know, your energy. So these are all tools to help protect you and to help you heal is the process of going away. And it could seem like at times, like I told you, I was like, God, like, I'm done with whoever is doing this crap. I'm so freaking done. I went off on a tangent, and I hadn't done that in a long time.